Humidity and bland aerosol therapy is a treatment method that involves the use of aerosolized mist to treat patients with respiratory conditions. It also involves the use of a nebulizer to convert liquid into water vapor and bland aerosols that can be inhaled into the lungs. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. First and foremost, what is humidity therapy? Humidity therapy is the process of adding water vapor to an inspired gas in order to treat a pulmonary disease. It is commonly used therapeutically to loosen up thick mucus and secretions from the airways of the lungs. In general, air is conditioned by the nose during inhalation, which adds heat and humidity as it passes through the upper airway. However, if the upper airway is bypassed, this is when humidification therapy would be indicated. The types of humidifiers that are used include bubble humidifier, passover humidifier, vaporizer, heat and moisture exchanger, and heated humidifiers. Humidity therapy is also indicated for the treatment of bronchospasm, non-productive cough, atelectasis, dyspnea, substernal pain, and airway dryness. So what is bland aerosol therapy? Bland aerosol therapy is the process of delivering liquid particles that are suspended in an inspired gas for therapeutic purposes. Some of the most common types of bland aerosols include sterile water, hypotonic saline, isotonic saline, and hypertonic saline. This type of therapy can be administered with or without supplemental oxygen, depending on the patient's oxygenation status. The delivery of bland aerosol therapy requires the use of a nebulizer. It's a device that uses compressed air or ultrasonic waves to break up liquid into aerosol particles that can be inhaled into the lungs. It requires the use of a face mask or mouthpiece in order for delivery to occur. The three types of nebulizers include jet, ultrasonic, and vibrating mesh nebulizers. Jet nebulizers are the most common type. This includes small volume and large volume nebulizers, which are commonly used in the acute care setting. Ultrasonic nebulizers use a piezoelectric crystal to generate aerosol particles by converting electrical signals into high-frequency vibrations. This type has the ability to generate a higher aerosol output than jet nebulizers. Vibrating mesh nebulizers use a mesh with tiny holes that vibrate at a high frequency to produce aerosol particles. These have the advantage of being able to generate a consistent particle size and have a higher respirable fraction than jet nebulizers. However, for bland aerosol therapy, we typically only use large volume and ultrasonic nebulizers. Small volume nebulizers are commonly used for aerosol drug therapy, which is a topic that we've covered in a separate video here on our channel. But again, for this one, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. But real quick, if you don't mind, please hit the like button to support the channel. I really do appreciate it. And be sure to subscribe for more videos like this. And just a final reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.